Hi everyone. There are a ton of new features for OSDCloud being released every week. Every time I log into Twitter, David Segura has released a new feature that is really interesting, mind-blowing, or just, I didn't even think it would be possible to do that. So you have to get started somewhere, right? So the idea of this video is to remove all the complexity and just say, how do we get started with OSDCloud? How do we get that first USB stick or that first ISO so that we can plug it into a VM or plug it into a laptop and try out all the cool stuff that David is bringing to Twitter and to the community. So that's what we're going to do. So if we take a look at the OSDCloud docs site, which is this bit here, you can see we've got some requirements. Now, I've been through this before in a longer video, which covered imaging surface devices from the internet, that sort of covered everything all in one go, and in this video I'm going to keep it really short and really sweet on just this particular topic. So we need Windows 10, and we need admin rights, we need internet, and we need to install the PowerShell module. So let's just start right there. I'm going to grab that code. I could click the copy button, but I'll grab that code, pop it into here, and run that. Okay, that took less than 30 seconds to do. So back to the website, we need the Windows IDK and WinPE add-on. I do have these, thankfully. I've got the assessment deployment toolkit here, and then this ridiculously big WinPE add-on at 5.4 gig. So that's all good. Make sure you grab those. I'll put links in the description of where to get it. Otherwise, you can grab it from this docs site here. We need to be willing to learn PowerShell, but really there's only a few commands that I'm going to be using for this, so we should be all right. So that's the requirements, that's the prereqs. We've got the module installed. So next, we will jump straight down to new OSDCloud workspace. And I'm going to grab this command here. In my case, I don't have a D drive, so I'm going to put it on an E. But that's the only change I'm going to make to this. I already have a directory called OSDCloud. There, but as you can see, it is empty. So I'll just run this command here. Okay, so it said it's done some things. Let's take a look at that again. Run a dir on that, and you can see it's created some stuff. Now, I'm not going to do anything with this stuff. I'm just going to leave it as it is. I've only run these two commands just to keep it nice and simple. Back to the docs. You can see we've got the contents. I'm not going to do any of this. I just want that new ISO that I'm going to create. So I'm going to type this command here. Do that there. Run that. And there we go. So in 6 seconds, that's not bad. We list that directory, you can see we've got a OSDCloud ISO. So let's see what happens then. So I'm going to put that ISO in a Hyper-V VM, OSDCloud demo one. I literally just created this machine a little while ago, so I'm going to have to just add a disk drive and point it at that file. There we go. So it's connected to my home network. I'm going to give it a few CPUs. Obviously, you don't need to give it a lot of CPUs and a lot of memory, but the more memory and CPUs you give it, the faster it will be able to do the build. So that's that. Enable TPM just for my own benefit, and then press OK. Right, so that's essentially me creating the virtual machine, which if you're going to use a physical machine, then you need to use Rufus or something to burn that ISO to a USB stick, but otherwise we're pretty much ready to go. I just need to start this machine and test it out. So it just asked me to press a key to boot from DVD. So doing that now. Okay, so that really is it. We're now in a WinPE environment where we can start running PowerShell commands to run OSDCloud or anything else that David comes up with in the next 24 hours since I've edited this video. So let's start with one of them, the one I know best. That's not going to work. I'm in command prompt. Let me try that. So just loaded into PowerShell, and now I'm going to try install module OSD. And so now we've got the module installed, it's just a case of starting OSDCloud. So we'll do start OSDCloud. So there we go, we've started OSDCloud. That is one way to do it. And you, as you saw, it's very, very quick to get to this stage. There are better ways, and there'll be a video next time which will show you much better ways to use this interface and to use that OSDCloud WinPE boot media that we've just created. For now, please hit the like button, please subscribe. I'm going to be trying to keep up with David with all the new content that he's putting out there. So there's a lot more content to come, a lot more videos and explainers and demonstrations to come. See you next time.